Sibiu is beautiful. I've never been, my first time in Romania, so I'm really happy to be here. I've known about Astra for years, and I've never had the opportunity to come, and to be here on the 25th anniversary is kind of special. I'm particularly happy that I was asked to serve on the Eastern European jury, because I'm being exposed to films and filmmakers whose work, some of whom I know, but many of whom I don't, and a real range of topics and storytelling styles. There's a particular quality in some of these films which I find so appealing. They're kind of author-driven, cinematic films. They're the kind of films that really speak to my heart, personally. And then to be exposed to the kind of issues that they're facing, I see parallels. You know, there's a number of films which are, you know, looking at the rise of the right wing and neo-Nazi movements in Europe. I see parallels in the United States. And it's really interesting to see how that is being talked about here, where there's obviously a traumatic history. That's really been illuminating. So I've been working in documentary film since 1999. Did a little bit before that, but really formally since 1999. Before my current job, which I'm now running an organization called the International Documentary Association, I was a commissioning editor, essentially. I was executive producer of a series called POV, which is on public television in the United States. It's the oldest series that focuses on showcasing independent feature documentaries. One of the things which I tried to do there in my time was to expand the kinds of films that were being shown on POV and have many more international stories. But I felt that IDA really had the potential to grow into something significant, so that's why I decided to join. And some of the things that we've done over the past couple of years is we started a new film fund. So we're now giving out about $1.4 million in grants every year, in production grants and development grants to filmmakers. We do a conference every 2 years. So we just had it last month, where we brought together 1,000 documentary filmmakers to Hollywood for 3 days, where they're looking at issues of, you know, distribution and marketing and production challenges and, you know, how do you make a living at being a documentary filmmaker, ethics, journalism, historical documentary storytelling. So a whole range of, I think we had 90 panels over 3 days for 1,000 filmmakers. We convened groups of, who were kind of mission aligned. So from the European Documentary Network, Turkish Filmmakers Association, groups from all around the world to see how we can be working better cross-border, internationally, to support each other. Because a lot of us are facing similar challenges. You know, challenges in public funding, challenges in censorship and free speech. You know, these are issues that everyone faces to one extent or another. So we feel that if we have a coalition of organizations, we can better have a louder voice in helping to support documentary filmmakers. The festivals I enjoy the most are outside of those big behemoth festivals, where I really get a chance to sit down and talk to filmmakers, to go to the tent late at night and have a beer with people. That happens more at festivals on this scale, where there's just more of an opportunity to breathe, to watch films, to sit down and socialize with people. So for me, it's fantastic. And the programming is fantastic. I'm coming here and I'm seeing films that I would never see anywhere else. And that's a real privilege. You know, I just saw two films last night, very different. A film called Anniversary, which is a portrait of this 92-year-old man and his family in a little village in the mountains. And it's so beautiful. It was so tender and beautifully constructed and aesthetically well thought out. And that to me is kind of one of the great joys of documentary films is I would never in a million years get access to this family or know these people. And I feel like over the course of an hour, I got to develop a little bit of a relationship with them. And so it's a real gift. I mean, it's a gift from the filmmaker to the audience, but it's also a gift from the people who participate in the films to the audience. And I think we often forget, you know, as people in this business, that the people who share their stories with us are being incredibly generous. Things have changed in the documentary landscape a lot over the past 20 odd years. You know, when I started, the marketplace, particularly in the United States, for documentaries were, there was some festivals, you know, Sundance being the big one and a few others. And then there was some television, POV and HBO was essentially it. Now the marketplace has really changed incredibly. There's many more films being released in theaters and having theatrical runs. There are many more documentary film festivals are around the country, and some really good ones in the United States and around the world. The marketplace for television and streaming has expanded enormously. So everyone from PBS and HBO, which have always been there, to Showtime and Hulu and Amazon and Apple and Netflix, obviously. And I think there's a real, you know, desire on the part of audiences for kind of the authenticity that comes with documentary storytelling.